This is it! Today, it has been 99 days since we started this series, and tomorrow, we are fighting the Herald. And I talked about the journey in the last episode. I have been enjoying this so much. And I added up the numbers, including the Herald fight, I will have had 25 episodes on Escalade 5 from this series. Add to that 39 behind the scene episodes, and 8, I actually don't know if it was 8, but somewhere around those lines of just random videos from the series, and you get a number of, I should have prepared this, let me just calculate, 25, 39, 8, 72 videos. That's quite a lot. And you know what's better is that I have had so much fun. Excuse me? Do you mind, sir? Oh, it's actually setting packed eyes. That's a terrible trade, actually. Terrible trade. I hammer you. Get taste by hammer. Stop spitting at me. This is not for llamas and wandering traders. He might have taken inspiration from Etho in the last one. Anyway, as I was saying, it's been great. It's been absolutely fantastic. And you know what's greater? Is that I have finished Pacific. That's right. Escalade 5 has finished something. It might not have been the original plan of making it all the way to Sky Limit, but I decided that the most important thing in order to finish Pacific was to at least get the same height it had on the Hermitcraft server in Season 7, which was 2 more layers for a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then the roof. The roof is very important. And here it is! It features the original rubber ducky flamingo, rubber duck, and whatever the red and blue thing is. It also features a hermit crab. Now, as you can see, if you're familiar with the original design, I decided to not carbon copy the original design. I thought it'd be more fun to just do Pacific 2.0 take on the roof. But I am very happy with how this turned out. We got the sunbeds and they are sittable. We got a nice bar and I invested quite a lot of vault gold and vault diamonds just to get a few different colored potions. Hello? Service, please. There's no one else here. Okay, I did ask Mumbo, but he's been busy. He hasn't responded. I did ask him to come in. We got the slides slightly upgraded, and I decided to go with this block here. This is a variant of wool that you can craft in Vault Hunters instead of water, because I tried to put water down and I just didn't like it. It just didn't feel very, it's like very dark blue water where I live, apparently. It's like that color there, and it just looked awful. And as I said, I chose to not carbon copy it, but still get that same vibe. And it's kind of like I have become a little bit older. This features a bar. The original one had a bigger slide. And it's not that I don't like slides, I love slides. But I think this turned out great. And I'm about to tell you all a little bit of a secret, because unfortunately, I don't have the squeaky stuff on the concrete, on the plastic. And here's the thing. 2 months ago, I asked my team to make me a block that would actually be plastic blocks. Because I did find the original squeaky sound thing, but I couldn't find the license for it. And I couldn't find where Mumbo originally bought the audio. So, unfortunately, I can't use it. But, all in all, I am extremely happy with the rooftop. And Pacific looks great. And I did decide to keep one original feature. And that is that Pacific is still pretty empty. Now, obviously, there could have been a ton of things that I could have put here. But as you all know, I've been focusing my efforts on getting all of the other hermits boosted up for those who needed dolls and those who needed burgers. I think I've contributed over 3,000 burgers at this point in time, and I don't have that many left. But the good news is that everyone who is joining the Herald, which I believe at the time of the recording, is going to be everyone except for Impulse and Vintage Beef. They're all level 100. Well, I don't actually know if Exuma has eaten the burgers yet, but he has been given enough burgers to make it to level 100. Well, I don't even know if he's been given the burgers or if they're just sitting in Etho's spawn machine over here. 382 and 15 of those. Yeah, he's gonna get there with that. Ooh, this looks amazing. This is where we're gonna go in. I assume. And look at how nice this area is looking. The hermits have been busy. Now, as for me, in addition to finishing the roof of Pacific and thereby saying that I've finished Pacific 2.0, I have created myself a build. As in like a build that I can use for the Herald fight. We had a bit of a discussion in the group. We wanted to mix it up. We wanted to have people that did damage or does damage. We want to have people that can handle large groups or AoE damage. And we wanted crowd control, we wanted support, and we wanted a tank. And since no one else said, yeah, I will go tank, I decided I shall be our tank. And I built a set that evolves around me, life leeching. I'm basically Vampire Skull. And also, this is me now. I am Velara's lost son, the grass-charming angel of doom. And I'm a vampire. It's a lot of things clamped in together. If you want to check out my gear, I highly recommend checking out the armory, vaulthunters.gg/armory. You can sit and you can take your time and look through all the different things. And same with my talents and abilities. But the base idea of this build evolves around my life leech lucky hit talent, as well as a lot of max health, which means that I will be running the giant's heart, which increases my health by a quarter. And I think in total, this is 44 hearts or 88 hit points, which is quite a lot. And that's important because the life leech talent will leech back life based on my max health. So since I have 88 hit points and level 2 in life leech, every time I proc a lucky hit, I will leech back 20%, which is 17.6 or 9 hearts or almost 9 hearts back every time I land a lucky hit. It's great. I'm basically immortal. Well, things can get a bit dicey. Me and Etho ran a fragged difficult vault the other day, and that video is available on Vaultskull. I'll put it down below in the description. It was really fun to see how this build and Etho's build stacked up against the hardest difficult in the game. Difficulty? Not difficult, hardest difficulty in the game. Anyway, with this all being done, I will be the tank in the final battle. Oh, and I completely forgot to say that this build also heavily relies on thorns. So things run up to me and they just die. It's very satisfying. But I did talk about wanting to make a Stompa build or Super Mario build. And while the other hermits want to do the AoE and damage builds in the Herald fight, I still want to do it, at least, if anything, to just showcase what can be done. And so I spent a little time this morning, not a lot of time, but I spent a little time this morning in re-rolling some of these gear pieces into hopefully being viable for such a build. I can still add a prefix here. I could get knockback resistance. Okay, so I can get knockback resistance, armor, or durability. So 1 in 3 that I would get the only modifier that I would care about for this build, which would be armor. And 1 in 3 is... that's not odds on my side, is it? But, I mean, we could get lucky. Here goes. Yes! There it is. 33% chance that we got the armor roll. Now, do I want to spend money on these? Like, I want the ability power to be at least above 45, but I have the lowest rolled armor possible, and I can use these fundamental focuses to get it up higher. Ah, what the heck? Let's give it a few spins. Yep, that's bad. That's bad. That's bad. 40.5, but 26 armor, so that's a lot more armor, and I lose a little bit of ability power, actually. The thing with the gear that I've collected here is that everything has increased ability percentage and legendary rolls. Actually, every single piece has increased ability power, which means that the more base ability power I have, the more valuable this percentage stuff is more valuable the more base ability power I have. This gives me 409, but let's just say if I would add like these leggings instead, I'm not just going to get the 38, I'm going to get 5,050, I'm gonna get a lot, basically. And on the contrary, I'm gonna lose a bit of mana. Mana is gonna be important here, but I've also tried to get a bit of mana regen so that I can cast my spells. That being said, I do have lucky hit on here. It's hard to tell what is best. I think this is a good start, though, to go with the 2640 and a total of 409 ability power. So, what I should do is go to this skill altar, and then I'm going to create a new one for my current build, which is my vampire build. And I'm going to label it with the vampire icon. And then before I finalize the gear or anything, let's have a look at what talents and abilities I want. So the whole premises of this build evolves around this ability, Hero's Landing. And I'm gonna need 8 skill points for that. So let's get rid of Hunter first and foremost. And I'm pretty sure I won't be using Javelins. Let's get rid of that. I will still want Dash. I don't need Nova or Frost Nova, so let's get rid of that for now. And in talents, I don't need strength. I'm not going to be doing physical damage. Probably don't need last stand. I mean, these are all nice talents to have. They're good for all builds, but I'm trying to prioritize. If I take all of my skill points out of javelin and enhancements, I should get a lot of skill points to spare. And luck hit, since this wand, I don't want to touch this wand because it's legendary. It does have a little bit of luck hit there, so I suppose that it's going to be decent to keep some luck hit. But I think what I can do is put all of it into mana leech. Right, so let's see. I'm definitely going to want intelligence. That's 12 more ability power. And because, as I said, I have so much percentage increase, I'm going from 409 and I'm going to add 12 through this talent. And that's going to not give me 12, but give me a lot more. I got 40 more, 39 more. And then, as I said, the whole build evolves around Hero's Landing. So let's maximize this and then select Hero's Landing. And now I should be able to see, yeah, I'm going to do 718 damage every time I proc this ability. And how do I proc this ability? Well, I do this, I fly up in the air, and then I land, causing a massive explosion to things around me. Wow, I really don't have many hearts with this build. And not very high defenses. Okay, I'm going to be a glass cannon. I'm also going to need some other attack skill, and since I'm a magician...
You're a wizard, Harry.
I'm going to want something that scales off ability power. There's Smite, there's Charm, there's the Storm Arrow, Fireball, Volley, and Fire Shot, as well as Nova and Poison Nova. Okay, I wonder if this is a... If I can combine two things here. Nucleus. Killing a stunned mob has a chance of causing an explosive reaction, casting a Nova off your level around the killed mob. This is 8 points, but let's see. If I go 8 points here, and then I level Nova up to level 8, and drink one of these regret flasks, Nova does 583 damage, but the goal isn't to be casting it like this. The goal would be to proc it, as in get it to happen, through this stun mechanic of Nucleus, which I'll get into in a little bit. Now, I do have 5 skill points remaining. I think it's fine to keep my masteries, because they're going to apply to ability power stuff as well. And I might just do this. I might go full on sorcery, because that's going to help my mana regen, and full on prudent, so I can drink my potion a lot. Might have forgotten something here, but we will see. First things first, though, I do need a new sword for this. I need a sword that has stunning on its suffix. And I have been saving... I don't have a single sword. I have been saving stuff here. You know what? This is a legendary shocking epic sword. I don't think anyone will go shocking though. So I am fine with re-rolling it. And hopefully over the series I've accumulated a few of these faceted focuses. These are great when you are looking to make a new item. So I put these in here and then I re-roll the entire sword. And that gives me a max roll of stun chance. And then the last thing I want is chaining, which I have discovered the 3 to 4, but not the 5 to 6. I feel like I'm okay to randomize this a little bit and hopefully land it. Actually, I shouldn't be doing that. I should be doing... Okay, there we go. And then I can chaotic focus this and try and get that to chaining 6. It's going to be a little bit expensive. Oh, or not. I'm just lucky, I guess. And then I would love to have undead damage here. So yeah, I do have this one unlocked. Craft that on. 58%. It's a bit of a low roll, but it's a fine start. The base stats, though, of this sword has 164 attack speed, and I want to be swinging as much as possible. I don't really care about the damage. 17 is good. Can I get better? 177 and 40. Wow, okay. That is going to be pretty fast. And one thing that would be better here would be to not have the attack range, but to have attack speed. But, I mean, it's good enough. I think this is good enough. Now, since a lot of the damage is supposed to come from my Hero's Landing ability. Oh, I actually have this armor as well. Just out of curiosity, my current Hero's Landing is dealing 718 damage, and that is with this chestplate. If I swap this chestplate so that I get 12 points in this ability, I would do 941. Wait, that's more, right? 941 versus 780. Wow, okay, so the +4 skills is much better, and I can still... while I could still reroll the implicits on this. I would lose mana, armor, cooldown, and mana regen though. And it would only work for Hero's Landing, and it would lower the damage for my Nova for that thing. To be fair, they look very similar, so it might not be easy for you lot to see what I'm talking about. Now, I think I'm going to keep with the ability power, because generically it's going to be better. Now, a lot of my damage is relying on me falling and doing damage like that. It's going to be scary, because I also take fall damage, but that's where this prismatic feather comes in. The thing that grants me triple jump. Whee! That's going to feel so weird to not have the elytra. So the idea is, and let's make sure I don't die here. Just randomly fall over while trying my build in the middle of Pacific. I'm really not that tanky. I'm really much of a glass cannon. But the idea is to jump up and then trigger Hero's Landing. Now, the greater the distance I fall, the bigger the radius that I explode in is. So it is valuable to fly higher than that, but the Prismatic Feather is going to help me assure me that I can consistently jump. Next up, I can take less fall damage if I get feather falling on here. This wand really doesn't have much durability. It's going to break pretty quick, but that's okay. I can reroll the implicits on it if it does. There I am, enchanted up. Actually, my sword. As I was saying, there I am. And the beautiful thing with this game is that as far as different builds goes, is I have the skill altar, so now I can go ahead and save this build. And I'm going to have the Stompa icon instead. And then what I can do is I can put down a wardrobe, and I can put in the gear for my other build, including my wings trinket and my giant's heart. And then I have it all saved, so I can just come over here and swap back. Actually, let me put my sword in there as well. Nice! And I can swap back and forth as much as I want. As far as my red trinket goes, I think I'm actually going to go the phylactery. This thing increases my total mana regen by 50%. And so I currently have 373, so I should end up having, let's see, 559. Yeah, that's gonna help out loads. So now I'm recovering 5.5 mana per second. I'm probably gonna die in this vault. I don't have a single extra heart, and I have 89 defense. I'm so fragile. But it should be fun to try it out. I don't want to be looking like this. We gotta go in with style. We gotta go in as the goat. Yes, there it is. You know what? Maybe we carry a wolf on our shoulder. We are all the animals here. I don't know why, but it's great. And everybody knows that Stompa is stomping best with the big with the big swimming slippers. I look like an absolute idiot. This is great. I'm 100% going to die in this vault. It's gonna be glorious. You know what? Let's go scavenger for this. I don't have hunters, so it is going to be more difficult. But it's a good way to, like, try out the build for real. Is pushing myself to having to do things in the vault. You know what? I think I just forgot my scavenger pouch. I did. Great. Absolutely brilliant. The scavenger is even not that... it's quite pretty difficult, actually. I need one of each chest. And I need a lot of items. Okay. Yeah, without Hunter, this is going to be hard. But actually, I think I can be a little bit smart here. Let's see. I have a lot of pouches. Can I change this to just load my scavenger filter, maybe? This one? Yes. That should work. My scavenger pouch is huge. It's fine. Right, let's see. Let's see if I can survive the first room. Now, remember, I am the goat, okay? And I'm using... this is an Aurum. I'll move on. I'm not using any defensive metrics. My helmet is legendary, but it is scrappy. It's lacking a lot of defensive capabilities. I just want to see how this works. I'm gonna try and spawn in stuff. And then I guess we'll see if we can kill them with this. Yes, we can! Oh! I forgot, I don't have any range skill, I don't have any javelins or anything like that, so I gotta attack them and hope for my stun to proc. Man, am I fragile, this is crazy. This is also not the best room because there's not a lot of space here. See if we can proc the nucleus. There we go, look at that! Oh, and I got the chainsword immediately. This is gonna be my nemesis, isn't it? Fighting against tank mobs. Okay, I just died from my chains, though. I could also just use Nova here, but I don't have to. Look, this doesn't cost me any mana. As long as I can get them stunned, Nucleus is going to cause the explosion. Watch. Oh, I missed. Okay. There you go. Cast Nova on my own. I should have taking some points into fire shot. That would have helped me so much here. I don't think I can do the. Can I do this mid-vault? I didn't think I could. Hold on, let's see. Oh, I can. Really? I guess because I had some unspent points. Okay, what else can I reallocate? Let's remove a vein miner. And I don't really want to remove any of these. I like stone skins. Ah, let's remove the stone skins. And I'm going to put them into the fire shot. Now, fire shot doesn't do a lot of damage on its own. Well, actually, with my current ability power, it kind of does. It's like a little ball like this. It's very easy to drain all your mana using it. But the beautiful thing with fire shot is that it uses my swords on hit. So it will also be chaining and stunning. And one-shotting, apparently. Look at that guy. I got a sack there. Nice. Oh, Falls also got chaining. That's funny. At the same time. At the same time. Now, let's see here. This obviously takes a little bit of practice and skill to do right. But ideally, I want to collect up as many mobs as possible. Oh, there's a dungeon there. I don't think this is going to be a good dungeon build. But yeah, I want to collect up as many mobs as possible and try and get, if I can, the entire room to spawn in. Because there's no limit on the amount of mobs I can hit with my hero's landing as long as I hit them. The only thing is that it gets more dangerous. Here we go. And that is why we call it a stompa build. Oh my, that was so satisfying. Look at them falling. And Fireshot does great here, actually. Yeah, Fireshot is amazing. Fireshot on its own doesn't do any AoE damage, so no area of effect. But it does chain. As I said, it uses my swords on hit. So as long as I have my sword selected, when I shoot the little ball, it will do the chaining, look at that. And then stun, and then everything sort of works together in a working symbiose. Now, I did see a dungeon in this room, and this is definitely not going to be a good dungeon clearing build, but I am going to open it. It's a skeleton one, challenging. I think this is a death trap, but I do need the sacks. Oh, this is where I die, because I can't use Stompa in here. I can do this, though. Okay. Oh, it's actually working pretty well. I gotta be very careful though. It's such a glass cannon build. I do a lot of damage with my spells. And my mana seems to be doing fine. That's a trinket. This is scary. Very scary when they come out of their stun and just charge towards me. There we go. Oh, those explosions are caused by nucleus and the stunning. There's a sack as well. Beautiful. I am a little bit scared of this champion to come here somewhere. Oh, is it this room? If I can stun lock him, as in keep him stunned, it should be fine. Hold on. Fire shot as much as I can. Nova. Oh, that's cheesy. Come through here. Oh, he died. I do a lot of damage. I do a lot of damage with this build. I mean, maybe that's as to be as expected with a full set of just legendary pieces, but still, definitely not as savage and safe as I am using my other build, as I am using my tank build. But again, that makes sense. I think that's the dungeon clear. Did I get all my sacks? 5 sacks is a lot. I got them! Yes! Okay, this is then totally winnable. I do need a lot of wooden chests, though. A lot of rift pages. And I don't have any treasure keys on me. Okay, here we go again. I'm going to try and collect up as many mobs as I can. All of these different POIs, that's a lot of slimes. Slimes are not ideal for this, actually, because they split into new slimes. Okay, hello, tanks. Hello, everyone. And then I wonder, should I just go down and, like, try and get the entire room? I think I've procced every single PO upstairs. POI, by the way. A lot of people have asked throughout the series, what is it saying? They say, why is it saying PUI? POI, point of interest, and what I'm referring to is any of these spawners and chests and all of that stuff. Right, there isn't a lot of ceiling height here though, unfortunately. Maybe I can make a little bit of space. Here we go. No, stop. Here we go. Woo! Okay, it's amazing. It's amazing, I can do it again. Yeah, there it is. There it is. That is so fun. And so very powerful against large amounts of mobs. Now, there are things I could do to make this better in terms of, like, my hit radius. I could... There's a statistic on helmets and wands, I think, called increase area of effect, which would add where this area is calculated, like how big the area is calculated. That would be very good to have. But for a slap together... A quick little stompa build on the side. It's great. It's absolutely great. It's by no means maximized, but it's good. Stompa time. there's pure joy. There's pure joy in this. And if you're ever wondering why we call it Stompa, it's because we stomp the mobs. Literally. I love it. I love it so much. It may not be the fastest I'm moving around or anything, but man, is it fun. As far as the scavenger goes, though, we're in trouble. I need 8 more ripped pages, 2 more Drownhide, and 6 more red scrolls. I kind of need to find a gilded special room or a gilded dungeon pretty soon, or this is going to be really tough. I still need more wooden, though, so I'm going to keep exploring. Oh, a champion tank. My fire shot does so much damage, though. Again, I may have been underestimating the value of having 4... Or 5, sorry, my wand as well. Is this a bit of power? Yeah, 5 perfectly rolled, or not perfectly rolled, but highly rolled ability power legendaries. Ooh, I'm very fragile though. Only 5-ish minutes remaining, and I'm almost there on the rip pages. I need 2 more Drownhide still, and then I need a lot of scrolls. This is gonna be close. But truth be told, I don't really care about the objective here. I just care about this. It's very satisfying. Come on, Drownhide. No, I don't want brain and arms. Oh, I only got 1. 1 more Drownhide and like 5 more red scrolls. I need a dungeon. Desperately. Oh, ask and one shall receive. Challenging. It's living. Yeah, this is not good. I'm gonna have to do this. Ninja, ninja, ninja. Ouch. I got the Drownhide. Okay, the living is done. I am so fragile. I'm so very fragile. I see some gilded chests, but even if I get a red scroll in all of these, that's not going to be enough. Ouch. That's 1. That's 2. That's 3. But it's not going to be enough. Move. Coming through. Ouch. Yeah, I got 6 red scrolls. I needed 2 more. That's okay. Without Hunter and first time just trying this build, I am very satisfied with this result. This was great fun and a fantastically fun build to just kill as many mobs as possible. I got 640 unalived. I mean, that's not mega numbers. But then again, I was trying to complete a scav. I only looted 18 gilded. 43 ornates though. I am going to call that, despite not winning, as you can see, I had all of the others. I'm going to call that great success. Get any super piece in here? I got a pair of epic leggings. I've been keeping everything that's epic or omega, and then other hermits have come to my house, or Pacific rather, and picked some stuff up. Ooh, omega leggings. And speaking about other hermits, some of the builds that I've seen that they have shown me look absolutely amazing. I think it's really exciting that we're all trying to go for a different style. And so the boss fight is going to be quite co-op. Anyway, with this Stompa goat build of doom, I look fabulous. With this goat build of doom, I can now go up to my wardrobe and then just click this button. And it will swap back all the items and it will save the Stompa in there. And then I can go into the skill altar. Although I do need a little bit of regret orbs. Them in here. And then I can just load back, just like that. I'm now back to being my vampire tank build of doom. Which, in case you're interested in seeing how it works, there are videos available on VaultScal where I run vaults with this build. And if you don't want to watch those, you'll see in the Herald fight. Because as I said, I'm going to be tank. Although I might post some more runs just running this, because it was really fun. Now with that said, that is going to do it. This has been an amazing series, and I hope that you're all excited for the finale. I am very proud that I did finish, quote unquote, Pacific, because there was a lot of other things to do in this series as well. And let me. It's not as good as the original. Thank you ever so much for watching. You gotta let me know your favorite moments from the series down below in the comments. And as I said, Final Battle is out February 1st, which I realize is not actually, we are not actually recording that thing tomorrow. It's what did we, there are 2 days left. I just realized it's 29th today. Not 30th. Got a bonus day. Oh, maybe I'll do some more stomp up. Anyway, if you did enjoy this video, please do hit the like button down below. And if you're brand new, consider subscribing. And I will see you in the next episode.